I always think it's helpful when you start any learning program to understand the definition that's being used for whatever the topic is. That is especially relevant when it comes to leadership. The other day, I did a Google search of the definition of leadership. I stopped at 100. There were at least 1,000. Here's the definition of leadership that we're using in UMO Leadership. Leadership is the process of engaging, equipping, and empowering people to understand, master, and own what they do. Every word in that definition is important. Let's start with the first one, process. A process is a series of steps organized in a particular way to achieve a specific outcome. So leadership is not a task. It's not a role. It's not something that you do on Friday at staff meeting. Those are parts of leadership. But leadership is a process. It's something that is done over time. It's about building culture. It's about how you interact with people. It's about how you engage people. It's how you build accountability. It's how you help people develop those three core personal attributes to thrive: awareness, initiative, and discipline. The second word is people. Now, there are a lot of things to do every day. Frankly, some days it just probably seems overwhelming. But at the end of the day, leadership is about people. Yes, there are tasks to do. Yes, there's technology to use. But at the end of the day, if you are leading, it means that you're leading a group of people. Now, there are three specific things in the UMO Leadership Model that you must master if you're going to be an effective leader: engaging people, equipping people, and empowering people. Let's start with engagement. Do you know who your people are? Do you know what your people's natural behavioral tendencies are? What are their goals? What are their dreams? What are the things that they bring to the workplace? Those are all key parts of what it means to engage people. You know, one of the interesting things that I find after teaching leadership for 25, 30 years now is that many leaders still struggle with engaging people. They struggle with understanding what it really means to engage. If you cannot engage people, it's really difficult to equip people and empower people. Here's another way to think about engagement. Can your people say yes to these four statements about you? My leader knows who I am. My leader values and cares about who I am. My leader believes that I have what it takes to be successful, and my leader wants to help me on the journey. When your folks can answer those four questions yes about you, then it means that you have engaged those people. Equipping. The reality is that people come to the workplace partially prepared, partially assembled. Some of them might be more assembled or more prepared than others, but everyone comes with work to be done. So a part of our role as leaders is equipping them to be successful in this organization and in this role. And finally, the last piece is empowerment. Empowerment, by definition, means giving people the power. As much as we wish everyone was a self-starter, the truth is most people are not. Most people are actually what we call adapters. They adapt to the environment in which they find themselves. They can rise to greatness. They can wallow in mediocrity based on how they are led. That's why leadership is so critical. So, a process to engage, equip, and empower people to do something. Now, what is that? At UMO Leadership, we believe that leadership is about more than just achieving tasks and achieving goals. UMO Leadership is about engaging, equipping, and empowering people to understand, master, and own what it is that they do. We want people to understand and embrace who they are, what they do, how they do it, who they do it with. We want people to become masters of what they do, not just competent at what they do. Mastery is the ability to successfully do something in a variety of complex situations without having to consciously think about it. So if you look at a mechanic that has mastered their craft as a mechanic, they almost do it without even thinking about it. They listen to a sound and they know what's going on within an engine or a motor. They observe, they look, they see, and then they move. If you look at a basketball player that's become a master of basketball, they don't think about dribbling, they just dribble. They don't think about shooting, they just shoot. Same thing with a pianist or violin player, is that they don't think about moving their fingers, they think about the music, because they have done it so long that they've actually mastered what they do. And finally, we want people who take ownership for what they do, not just simply become compliant with the expectations for this particular role. It's one of the real shifts and changes in this extraordinary and complex world that we live in. We don't need people who are simply compliant with expectations. We need people that own what they do, see the possibilities out there, see what needs to be done, anticipate what's going on, and react to that in ways that help them thrive and help organizations thrive. So that's the definition of leadership that we're going to use in UMO Leadership. Creating a process that engages, equips, and empowers people to understand, master, and own success.